A major goal of asthma care is to achieve a level of well-controlled asthma. When asthma is well-controlled, patients should have minimal or no symptoms and be at their lowest risk for exacerbations. Many patients overestimate their level of asthma control, demonstrating that they often tolerate more frequent and bothersome symptoms and exacerbations than ideal. Findings from the Asthma Insight and Management Survey show that a majority of patients, approximately 71%, categorize their asthma as either completely or well controlled. However, when looking at the NAEPP criteria for asthma control, a majority of patients, approximately 71%, would be classified as either not well or very poorly controlled. Furthermore, findings from a Canadian survey of specialists and PCPs showed that 90% and 88% of their patients respectively were controlled, but only 47% of patients surveyed had controlled asthma per symptom-based guideline criteria. Many studies describe this discordance between patients and healthcare practitioners, or HCPs, with regard to the perception, assessment, and acceptance of the patient's level of asthma control. For this reason, it's generally helpful to use clinical tools to objectively assess each patient's asthma control. Several tools are widely available to help patients and HCPs assess the level of asthma control and thus identify patients who might benefit from adjustments in therapy to achieve control. Examples include the Asthma Control Test, ACT, and the Childhood ACT. These tests use a series of patient and parent-completed questions to develop a control score. Scores of 20 or higher represent well-controlled asthma, while scores of 19 or lower represent uncontrolled asthma and should prompt evaluation for factors that contribute to uncontrolled disease and may warrant a step up in treatment. Another way to assess symptom control is a semi-quantitative approach suggested by the Global Initiative for Asthma, or GINA, which asks four yes or no questions. A yes response to any of these indicates uncontrolled symptoms. Questionnaires like these can be completed in a very short amount of time. Most have low administrative burden and are easy to score. The questionnaires can provide the HCP with additional information to augment their overall assessment of their patient's asthma control. For the patient, results should be easily obtained and easily explained, allowing patients to follow their asthma action plans, which are based on their level of asthma control. In addition, scores can be tracked over time by both HCP and patients to monitor changes in asthma control due to therapy changes or other factors. Well-controlled asthma is one of the main goals of asthma management. Focusing on identifying patients whose asthma is not well-controlled is essential, and tools are widely available to assist in this determination. Better detection of uncontrolled asthma should lead to intensification of asthma therapy in order to gain better control.